So, in my previous videos about nakshatras, we have discussed what is the role of nakshatras in judging the life events and how they modify the results given by a planet in the natal chart. So, I would just give you the summary what we have discussed in our previous video. If the results given by a planet is good or bad as according to its position in sign and houses and its relationship to other planets, whether it is good or bad. Suppose if a planet is situated in a good or malefic houses or is conjunct by a or aspected by a benefic or malefic planet. In that case, the results of the planet will be either good or either bad. So this good or the bad results of a planet is modified by the planets, those who are situated in the nakshatras of the said planet. So the good results can be more good. The good results of a planet can be more good if it is situated in a functional benefic planet, if it is situated in a natural benefic planet, or if it is situated in the nakshatras of a planet which has having the same and good signification. Suppose Jupiter is situated in the nakshatras of Saturn. In that case, the person that is will having the qualities of Jupiter, such as benevolence and serving to others, these qualities will be modified by the judiciousness of Saturn. The person will have some inherent quality to first judge a people and then serve him or serve her. So the qualities of Jupiter is modified by Saturn because it is situated in its nakshatras. Similarly, if Saturn is situated in the nakshatras of Jupiter, then the auspiciousness of the Saturn will be increased because Saturn is situated in the nakshatras of Jupiter. Similarly, if Rahu is situated in the nakshatras of Venus, then because Rahu and Venus are friend, both Karkas are friend, both are having same significations, some significations same, and Venus is a Daitya Guru, so Venus is the teacher of the demons. In that case also, the Rahu is situated in the nakshatras of Venus, so Rahu is situated in the nakshatras of its guru. So in that case also it will be beneficial. So we have to look all the factors, like whether a planet is situated in the nakshatras of a planet, whether it is a functional benefic planet, whether it is a functional, whether it is a natural benefic or malefic planet, whether it is a functional benefic or a malefic planet, or whether its signification as a karkas are same or not. Suppose if a planet Venus is situated in the nakshatras of Saturn, then in case what will happen? Venus is a diplomat and Saturn is again a diplomat. So that person will be a great diplomat. And if suppose Venus is situated in the nakshatras of Moon and Moon is irrational, in that case the person will not be as diplomatic because it is situated in the nakshatras of Moon. So the result given by the Venus, that is diplomacy, is somehow modified by the irrational nature of the Moon. So in that case, the results of a planet is modified as according to the nature of the planet that sits in its nakshatras. So these were the discussion we held in our previous videos. And one more thing I would like to add is the interchange of the planet as nakshatras. Consider the case of Pisces ascendant. Suppose Jupiter, here it is a lord of the first and the 10th house. Now 10th house is a house of authority, 10th house is a house of society. As 7th house is also a house of society and authority in some case, in some extent. So here Jupiter has a lord of the first and the 10th house. If Jupiter is situated in the nakshatras of Sun, that is Sun in this case is a lord of the sixth house. So what will happen? There will be a conflict in authority.